My name is John Albert Emperador from BPAC 2020, and this is my report about Presidential Decree number 807. Presidential Decree number 807. Presidential Decree number 807, October 6, 1975, Civil Service Decree of the Philippines redefined the role of the Commission as the central personal agency of the government. So, ano naman ang meron dito sa Article 1, Section 1? This decree shall be known as the Civil Service Decree of the Philippines. Herein rules on appeal filed by state, county, and municipal civil service employees, candidate for employment, and appointing authorities. Okay, Article 2, Section 2. It shall be the policy of the state to ensure and promote the constitution mandate that appointment in the civil service shall be made only according to merit and fitness provided within the public service, a progress system of personal administration, and to adopt measures to promote moral and the highest degree of responsibility, integrity, loyalty, efficiency, and professionalism in the civil service. That the Civil Service Commission shall be the central personal agency to set standard and enforce the law and rules governing the selection, utilization, training, and discipline of civil servant. That public office in public trust and public officer shall serve with the highest degree of responsibility, integrity, loyalty, and efficiency, and shall remain accountable to the people, and that action on personal matter shall be decentralized with the different department and other offices or agency of the government delegating to their regional offices under similar units, power, and function. So, dito sa Article 2, dito ay pinapakita ang pagpapatibay ng mga hakbang upang itaguyod ang moral at pagiging tapat at responsable sa mamamayan. Okay, next forward to Article 6, Responsibility of Public Officer and Employees. So, dito sa Section 15, duties of public officer, public office is the public trust, public officer, and employee shall serve with the highest degree of responsibility, integrity, loyalty, and efficiency, and shall remain accountable to the people. So, dito naman sa Section 15, ang mga tungkulin ng mga pampublikong opisyal. Ang pampublikong opisina ay isang pampublikong tiwala. Ang mga pampublikong opisyal at empleyado ay dapat maglingkod na may pinakamataas na antas at responsible at may katapatan at kahusayan sa pananatili at pananagutan sa mga tao. Okay, next is Section 28, Career and Personal Development. The development and retention of a competent and efficient workforce in the public service is a primary concern of government. It shall be a policy of the government that continuing program of career and personal development be established for all government shall serve as the basis for all career and development activities in the government. So, dito naman sa Section 28 ay pinapakita na dapat pagpatuloy ang mga nasimulan na programa ng naunang termino like ang K-12, dahil kung gagawa ng bagong programa ay tiyak na mag-uumpisa ulit at kailangan maipaunlad ang nasabing at naunang programa.